I'm Nigel Austin. I'm the BC principal of Maple Leaf International School, Chongqing.
Hi, I'm Yasher Karamati. I am the BC program vice principal.
We'd like to show you around the school today and see what it's like to teach at Maple Leaf.
Come with us.
Hello, my name is Nadia. I'm a teacher at Maple Leaf Educational Systems, and I am very passionate about keeping healthy active living as well as balance in my life. I went to university at the University of Toronto, and it was in the St. George campus right in the middle of Chinatown, and it helped me develop a nice feel for Chinese culture, which is most likely what brought me here to China to teach at Maple Leaf. At first, I decided to come to Maple Leaf because I wanted to develop more experiences in teaching and putting a lot of the things that I learned in school into practice within my actual classroom and outside of the classroom, developing different types of activities and strategies to help students learn in many different ways.
My name is Carly Egan. I went to the University of Ottawa, where I studied English and French. After that, I did my bachelor's in education at the University of Windsor, which is where I'm from. I decided to come to Maple Leaf because I knew someone that was working here and someone that I had gone to teacher's college with. So I asked her about her experiences here in China and here at Maple Leaf in particular, and she was loving it. She only had positive things to say about the school and the culture of China and the environment, the atmosphere, so I decided that I would give it a try.
Activities. Every month we have what's called a PDSB on campus, which is a half day Friday for students, and then teachers get together and we do professional development activities on various topics, and then a staff building activity with the Chinese staff and ESL staff, which has been quite successful. We also do a thorough orientation in August, and during exam time have other department time to talk about what's going on at the school. Inside the classroom, our class sizes are actually quite small. Our average is about 23 this year. Some classes get up close to 30, but we don't have any over 30. Some of our electives are, I think we had some classes 12, 13 this year. So class sizes vary, but average about 23. One thing that I like at our school is the cafeteria. I've worked at three different campuses, and Chongqing cafeteria is actually quite good. We have a smoothie bubble tea stand, a fruit store, a private area where staff can eat lunch and avoid the lineups of all the students on campus. And we also have a big store downstairs that you can order or you can buy whatever you need. The best thing of all is the students. We have some great kids, a really friendly teaching staff. Our support staff is very good. We have many Chinese staff that their job is to help us and support us on things we need to do for field trips and activities in the community.
We have a very active staff here in Yongchuan. Our teachers like to play a lot of sports and do various activities. So every Friday after work, they get together and they play different sports. There's lots of good turnout and enjoyment from the teachers. We also have nearby many lakes and mountains to hike. We even have teachers participating in marathons. It's a very active environment, so lots of things to do. I personally play in a community soccer team with some other adults, and it's a lot of fun.
Hi, my name is Aris. I'm a foreign affairs secretary in Chongqing campus. I'm here to help you to apply your Z visa, your foreign affairs act certificate, resident permit, which are essential to help you stay in China legally. And I also will help you to hunt your apartment, set up your bank card and SIM card, if you feel sick, I will take you to see the local hospitals and see local doctors. This is what I do here.
Well, ESL program is a quite special program because we have both Chinese bilingual teachers and international teachers working together to help students whose English level is not high enough or good enough to take BC academic courses in the senior high school to improve their English.
What I think about Maple Leaf is quite friendly because everybody here is always willing to help, willing to offer you some help. And if you don't have someone to film something and you can ask them for help. And Maple Leaf is a place offers many chances and it doesn't require a lot of solid ability. If you're just interested in this activity, you can just join it and you can participate in it. And you can get a lot of friends, a lot of experience here. And I'm very proud of to be a Maple Leaf student here.
On the one hand, I think all the teachers and students get along with each other very well. And secondly, I think Maple Leaf is a good atmosphere to study and to learn from each other. So I think just join us because Maple Leaf and all the students and teachers won't let you down.
大家好, 欢迎大家来到重庆枫叶国际学校。 因为重庆是中国的四个直辖市之一，这里有美丽的母亲河长江，也有闻名遐迩的大足石刻，还有成都的大熊猫，还有享誉世界的重庆火锅。大家在周末工作之余，还可以到永川的各大旅游景区去饱览中国的乡土文化。 重庆枫叶,
I hope you found this video informative. If you're interested in coming to Maple Leaf, I hope you can go online and contact your local recruiter or send me or Mr. Karamati an email with any questions you might have about the Chongqing campus. Whether you're a new teacher coming right out of college or a veteran teacher or a teacher who's just retired and wants to come check out China and travel and teach, I hope you give Maple Leaf a shot. I know you won't regret it.